Tell somebody, tell three people I love praising God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to do it one time. I just want everybody just stand up for 1 second. Just 1 second. Just 1 second. Look to your neighbor and say, I love praising God.
I love praising God.
I love praising God. Now I want y'all to look at me just for a moment. Give me. Look to your neighbor and say, I love praising God.
I love praising God.
Let me show you. Come on, you just tell them, I love praising God. Let me show you and just get you a little. Yeah, you just give them a little bit. Just give them a. That's all. You don't have to do much. I don't want to wear you out. I don't want you to say, man, I went to that pastor's church, and he had me stand up the whole time, and I was tired. No, I want you to just stand up for a little bit and just give him a little. Somebody say, I need to praise God now and then. Come on, because when I praise God, something happens. Hey! Heaviness leaves.
Oh, I gotta praise, I gotta praise, and I gotta get it out. I gotta pray. Come on, everybody shout, I gotta pray.
Y'all doing good for a 9 o'clock service.
I gotta praise.
What you got? What you got? Look to your neighbor and say, that's what I do. Good. Tell them that's how I praise them. Tell them I got a little something, something in the tank. Look to your neighbor and say, I got a little something, something in the tank. A little praise in there. Now listen. It looks like some of y'all really like this. I wonder why. I know why. I'm going to tell you why. Watch this. You ready for it? The Bible says laughter does merry like a medicine. So God pre-wired you for healing. He put medicine in your body. He put it in your makeup. All you got to do is laugh and it releases medicine. Medicine heals. So when you laugh, medicine is released. For whatever problem that you're dealing with, it's supernaturally released. Come on, somebody. Let's talk about praise. See, I know why you like the praise. See, God put it in you. Look to your neighbor and say, it's already in me. See, when you praise, the walls come down. Y'all didn't hear me. See, when you praise, the walls come down. When you let out a shout of praise like they did in Jericho, the walls begin to fall. That's why you like praising God, and you can't stop because it feels good, because your breakthrough is in the praise. Come on, somebody. Look. Look to your neighbor and say, the breakthrough is in your praise. Y'all don't hear, I'm teaching. See, the breakthrough is in your praise because before the walls came down, come on, they were praising God. They were doing, they sought God. They were walking around doing what God said, but the walls were still up. It wasn't until they opened their mouth and praised God that the walls fell down. Look to somebody and say, when you praise God, everything you pray, everything God said that he was going to do for you, it's going to come to pass. That's why you can't just go into prayer and hear God and hear what he said he's going to do. You can't just hear his word and know what he's going to do, but don't praise him for what he's about to do. Somebody just go ahead and praise God. The organ, turn it up. Oh. This does not feel like a 9 a.m. service. I think praise is better than coffee. I know it is. Go ahead, tell your neighbor, praise him. Says praise him in the dance. Praise him in the dance. Look to your neighbor and say praise him. Neighbor and say, give him a high five. Give him a high five. Say, you're praising yourself into healing. You're praising yourself into better relationships. God is sending people to you just by you praising him. Because you're praising him, God is sending openings. Look to somebody and high five and say, God is sending breakthroughs. Come on, God is sending greater favor to you. Come on. Because you're praising him. Come on, you're not stuck. Come on, praise him anyhow. Praise him this. Despite what's going on. Pastor Tim, come up here. Pastor, Prophet Cynthia, come. You two, both of you, come. Go ahead, do it. Do it over here, Pastor. All right, we got the Israeli praise, and we got the African American praise. Can I get some? Give me the Italian praise. I want Italian praise. Italian, hey. We got all kind of praise. Any other kind of praise? Any other praise? Come on. Where praise is at? This is Jamaican praise. Jamaican praise. Praise. my millennial praise. Millennial praise. My millennial. I want to end. I do want to just give you something real quick, but I need a millennial. I need somebody to come up here and break it down. Come on. Where's my young millennial? Nobody? I don't have any this service. Okay. I'm going to let y'all go. I'm going to let y'all slide today, but at the 9 o'clock. Look to your neighbor and say, get your praise on and keep it on. Uh-oh. Toby, you don't want to stop, do you? Come on, Toby. Come on, Toby. One more, what? Hallelujah. Yes, give him a shout. Give him a shout. Look at your neighbor and say, that feels good, doesn't it? Come on. Come on, go ahead and high five your brother or sister. Tell them that feels good, that feels good, that feels good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I feel that. Come on, I feel that. Woo! It's hard to stop that sometimes, you know. Look at your neighbor and say, I love praising God. Wasn't that fun? But check it out. See, what happens is you really know that praise is for God. And as you get into it, your whole body just goes. You just let go and you give your whole self to God in the praise. Amen. Come on. And it's fun. Amen. How many enjoy praising God? Look to your neighbor and say, I see that big old smile on your face. I see that. Amen. Woo. Hallelujah. Just hold hands. Hold your neighbor's hands. Just hold your hands. If you know me and my wife, Prophet Cynthia, you know that we do not play church. We don't just go through the motions. We don't lead you somewhere where we're leading by the carnality, by the flesh. We're always leading by the Spirit because we're hoping that you would believe that and follow us to something good, something great, something more. Not from us, but from God. He says, praise me. Amen. In the sanctuary, praise me with the harp and amen, the psalteries, praise him, everything that has breath, amen, everything that has breath, the lion, the tiger, the bear, the horses, everything that has breath, let it all praise me, And when we begin to praise him, I just believe that everything that we're dealing with drops off. Amen. So let's just say, Father, we thank you that we can praise you in the dance, in jubilation, in joy, in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, as they hold hands, continue to open up their eyes of understanding concerning praise as we go into 40 days of praise and teaching, Father. Open their eyes, Father, to what praise does and why we praise. In Jesus Christ's name, how we get to praise, how it happens. In Jesus Christ's name, we bless you, we praise you, we honor you in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Hallelujah. Man, I just feel like just praising right out of the service. And I just see y'all dancing out of the service, going home dancing. Look to your neighbor and say, I will be dancing out of here. Go ahead and high five your neighbor and say, I will be dancing out of here. And I'll be dancing at the restaurant today. I'll be dancing at my house watching a football game and taking my nap right before my nap. I will be praising them. Amen. While I just get out of my clothes and get into my comfy, my nap clothes, and I'll be praising them on the way to my nap. Hey, y'all think I'm playing, right? The devil comes to steal our joy. Come on. Come on, the garment of heaviness. Amen. The spirit of heaviness that comes like a coat. The Bible says the garment of praise. Put it on. Look to your neighbor and say, just put on the garment of praise. When things get heavy, come on, I know things get heavy. Just tell them, just put on the garment of praise. It may take you a while to stir it up, amen, but put it on. Come on, it may not happen right away, but put it on, because that heaviness will leave you. Look to your neighbor and say, I feel relieved right now. I feel relieved. I feel good. Tell them I feel good. How many know that's true? Okay, I'm going to leave y'all alone because I feel like dancing some more. How many used to go to the nightclub? You better watch it. How many used to go to the nightclub and would close the club because you're out there dancing on the dance floor? Put your hand up, tell the truth. Shame the devil. All right, who would least dance on the dance floor when you went out into the clubs when you were unsaved? Put your hands up, okay? All the clubbers, put your hands up. Serious. People gather to dance. Amen. And how many dance with all their heart? You dance like David, right? How many were at the club but you didn't dance because you just can't dance? Just tell the truth. Oh, I knew. I was wondering why everybody's hand wasn't up. So I had to. The Lord says they all can't dance, but they were at the club. And they were standing there watching. They're like, boy, I wish I could do that move. Man, that's bad. But I ain't going out there. But you were there and you saw what they did when they went there. They went there to dance and, you know, really dance. And if I could dance out there, I could dance in here. If you danced out there, you should be able to dance here. Amen. You should praise God. Amen. Glory to God. So let's make sure that we look to your neighbor and say, remember that. If you danced out there, if you stood and watched people dance, you can dance in here. Tell them. Amen. So tell them, don't be afraid to dance unto the Lord. Don't be afraid to dance unto the Lord. He's watching you. It pleases him. Amen. When you dance in a praiseworthy way to give him praise. Amen. Come on. Because when you're praising, when you're dancing, you're just like excited at what he's done. The only reason why you're dancing is because he did something. Come on, somebody. The only reason why you're dancing is not just to fill your flesh. You're dancing because he did something. Come on, somebody. Something happened. Come on. There was a suddenly. Come on. There was a suddenly. God moved. He swept in, helped you out, fixed you, healed you. Come on, somebody. Blessed you. Come on, gave you what you needed. When you thought you wasn't going to get it, it showed up. Hey, Shandarabosha. That's why you dance. Hey, look to somebody. Say, that's why I dance. Tell them, that's why you dance. Tell somebody else, that's why you dance. That's why you shouted. That's why you gave God praise. That's why you lifted your hands. That's why you just started calling people up, telling them, I gotta tell you what God did. Look to somebody and say, don't look at pastor like that. Don't look at him like that. That's why David danced. I'm all in the teaching already. But that's why David danced. God did something and David danced. God gave him the ark back. God gave his presence back. The greatest thing that God could ever do is give himself. And he gave himself back to Israel in the form of the Ark of the Covenant. And David, their leader, did what? He danced. Come on, somebody. That's the kind of leader you need. To your neighbor and say, didn't he do it? 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 He did it. He did it. He did it. Didn't he do it? Didn't he do it? Look to your neighbor and say, go ahead and you know he did it. You can dance. Got my football touchdown end zone dance on. Got my end zone dance going on. But this is the glory house, the glory dome dance, the house of God in the sanctuary dance. Because I'm thankful for what he's done. I'm thankful that I could be in the house of God. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm thankful that I could be in the house of God. Woo! David danced because God's presence was back in Israel. Anybody saved? Anybody got the presence of God inside? Look to your neighbor and say, he's on the inside. Keep your praise. So David was a man after God's own heart. When God gave him his presence back, David danced. David was not ashamed to dance. And he danced in a way in which all his clothes came off. Listen to what I'm saying. Those are the kind of people you need to be around. See, you got people that are sitting. I'm tired. I know you better not be tired. You're younger than me. So David dancing, look to your neighbor and say, you can dance if you're really saved. You can praise. Now, I'm not saying we praise all day long, right, on the dance, but we praise him by just giving our lives to him 24/7. Come on, somebody. That's a praise to God. Look to your neighbor and say, I want you to follow people, hang around people, partner with people, befriend people that don't mind praising God in front of you. We don't need no secret praisers. We don't need somebody that prays when ain't nobody looking. Come on. We need people that can praise God up in the sanctuary, up in your house, at Thanksgiving family dinner, come on, family gathering, we need somebody that can give God the praise. Look to your neighbor and say, go ahead and give God the praise. On the inside, if you love God, you don't need anybody to help you praise God. Just let it out. Be free. Look to your neighbor and say, be free. Go ahead and tell three people, be free, because you really do love God. Don't let your past failures prevent you from being free. Just go ahead and be free. With God, to God, from this day forward, in Jesus Christ's name, amen and amen. Don't let anybody lock up your praise from this day forward, in Jesus Christ's name. I said, don't let anybody lock it up. Don't let anybody take your praise from this day forward, in Jesus Christ's name. Look to the person next to you and say, just give me a shout. Just give me a shout. Come on, just keep saying it. Keep saying it. Keep saying it until they give you a shout. If they didn't give you a shout, keep telling them, yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This is going to be a greater day. Come on, somebody. Look to your neighbor and say, a greater day. Somebody is praising God right now, and it's out of their spirit. They can't help it. They can't stop it. It's pouring out like rivers of living water. It just pours out like a faucet. It just pours out. Come on, somebody. Like the fire hydrant up in New York City and Jersey in the summertime. It just pours out. The water just pours out. And people start gathering around the fire hydrant because they're hot. Come on, somebody. And the water's coming out of the fire hydrant. Come on. And everybody's a part of that. They're coming because it cools them off. Look to somebody and say, let that river flow out of you. Come on. There's some people that need some changing. They need some cooling off. With the Holy Ghost that's inside of you. Come on, somebody. Just let it out. Amen. All right, that's enough preaching this morning. Go ahead and take your seats. Come on, amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But I'm telling you, it feels good when you're free to praise God. Amen. Look to your neighbor and say, and tell them, stay free. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Well, I need to, how do you transition from this, right? You see, it's so much going on right now. You just want to keep on going. But I want to just give a couple announcements before I get started, amen? I want to thank everyone that came out to the assessment. If you came out, just wave your hands. You helped us out. Amen. It's so important that we continue to model the early church. Amen, which means that whatever God wants, we want. And one way to do that is to make sure that we are serving the people here at Proclaim. And the way we get to know if we're serving the people is we do assessments. We get to hear your opinions, hear what you feel about this church and how it's moving. Amen? And we need your input. Look to your neighbor and say, they need our input. Pastor Billy needs our input. Amen? And so it helps us to help you. And here's an example. Check this out. Acts 6:13 says this, and in those days when the number of the disciples were multiplied, as churches grow, and we're growing here, there arose a murmuring of the Grecians against the Hebrews because their widows were rejected in the daily ministration. Okay? So there was something going on out there. And when the leadership got wind of it, they moved to fix it. Amen. Wherefore, brethren, look ye out among you seven men of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business, this in-house business. Come on, somebody. Amen. So there's murmurings, there's lack, there's needs in the congregation, and until we know about it, we can't do anything about it. Come on, somebody. Amen? That's why I tell you guys, if you get sick or you have to be away for a while or something's going on, call the church, let us know. Oftentimes I go up to people and I say, where you been? They say, oh, I was sick or I had this happen. And I said, really, I didn't know. And did you call the church? Did you tell anybody? They said, no, I didn't. Forgive me, Pastor. Well, we'd like to know, amen? Look to your neighbor and say, let Pastor know. Please, amen. And so that's what happens, and this here assessment allows us to get a pulse of where the people are concerning this church so that we can make changes, so that we can do a better job. Look to your neighbor and say, let's do a better job serving. Amen. Well, we have announcements. I'm going to let those announcements run, and it's so late. This was my message. Amen. I can't give you guys anything. I can't teach. It's 10:22. Amen. But you know I'm going to give you one scripture, right? Look to your neighbor and say, yes, he is. Amen. I'm going to give you one scripture. Go ahead and run the announcements, you guys. All right? And then I'll give you my one scripture. The Bible says that God is going to turn everything that is against us around for our good, right? So we can go into prayer and ask God to do that, but think about it. If his word says that he's going to do that, then just agree with the word. So when you go into prayer, say, Father, I thank you that you're going to turn it around for my good. I'm not asking you to. I'm asking you to do what you already said you're going to do. I thank you for turning it around. Come on. So we're not going to go in and say, Father, you know, when something bad has happened, say, Father, I pray that you turn it around for our good. You go in saying, Father, I thank you that you are going to turn this around for our good. You are. You can talk to God like that. You are going to turn around for our good. Why? Because you said you would. You can talk to him like that because he's not like our earthly fathers. See, the Bible says our heavenly father is not like earthly fathers. Because when you ask an earthly father to give you bread, he may give you a stone. God says that. But if you ask your godly father, heavenly father, for bread, he will give you bread. And if he said he would give you bread, he will give you bread. He keeps his word. So write that down, amen? Whatever God says in his word, that's what we pray. We pray what he says. Amen. So I heard the announcement, so that's why I said that. Amen. Let's pray, ask God to turn it around. Amen. No, we say, God, thank you for turning this around. Come on, somebody. Anybody got that? Turn it. Okay, great. Hold on 1 second here. I picked out one scripture, right? And I didn't write it all down because I was praising God too much. No. Hold on. Turn to 1 Chronicles 29, verse 10. 1 Chronicles 29, verse 10. I just had Chronicles, and I'm like, okay, which one was that? Was it 1st, 2nd? You have it, say glory. Somebody say examples of praise. David was a man after God's own heart. Now listen to how David talks to God, amen. Look how David lives, what he does.
First Chronicles 29, verse 10 says, so David blessed the Lord in the sight of all the assembly. David praised the Lord, amen, in the sight of all of the assembly. In front of everybody, he was not ashamed to praise the Lord. In front of everybody. Somebody say, in front of everybody. When there's moments of praising God, a praise moment in the church of even just shouting out hallelujah or saying yes, you ought to take advantage of that. Come on, somebody. How many have felt in your spirit there's times when you wanted to just say hallelujah or yes, pastor, amen. Come on, somebody. Just wave your hand and make the devil ashamed. Come, make him a liar. Wave, tell the truth in the church. There's times you're sitting there, you know, man, hallelujah, yeah, amen. See, when you're saying amen, you're saying praise God. Come on, somebody. Even though amen means let it be, amen, let it be as God said, let it be. He is the I am, so everything he says is already. So if he speaks it, it is. Regardless of what you think about it, if God says it, it is. So therefore, the am, the amen is saying let God's word be. Let what God wants be. Let God's will be done. Why? Because God spoke it. And if God spoke it, there's nothing you can do about it. There's nothing the earth can do about it. There's nothing that aliens, amen, demons can do about it. It will manifest as God said. So all you should do, be wise and just say amen. Just say amen. Say amen. Whatever God says, just say amen. Come on, amen. Amen. This is the generation, the Bible says, that seeks after God. Come on, somebody. This is, if you are that generation, and it's not everybody, when it says this is the generation that seeketh thee, Lord, that seeketh after thee, it's not everybody, but it's talking about a movement within the church. Come on, somebody. And everybody's not moving in the church to seek God. Come on, somebody. See, everybody's not moving in their hearts, in their spirit, to seek God. They're seeking other things. But this is the generation that will rise up, amen, in the last days, in the end times, that will seek God. And they are the ones that have the amen coming out of their mouths. They don't wrestle with God. They don't question God. They just say, this is what God says. Amen. Let it be, as you said. Amen. And so you're not afraid to who's around. You will bless the Lord. You will praise God. Because he is God. Amen. He's sovereign. So the Bible says that he did it in the sight of the assembly. And David said, blessed are you, O Lord, God of Israel, our Father, forever and ever. Yours, O Lord, yours, O Lord, is the greatest and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. Amen. It's just like what's on the wall back here. At the end of the prayer in Matthew 6, amen, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. But David adds some more stuff, amen. David has always been elaborate, over the top. Look to your neighbor and say, you can never say enough about God. Oh, you need to tell your other neighbor, you can never say enough about God. And David understood it. That's why he was a man after God's own heart. Not that he was just running after God's heart. He was exemplary of God's heart in his actions. He modeled God's heart. 24/7, David moved in the heart of God. And when he didn't, he was quick to repent because he knew this was not God. How many times you've done something you knew it wasn't God? Did you repent right away? Quickly? Because David did. And that made him a man after God's own heart. So listen to this. It says, greatness, power, the glory, and the victory, and the majesty. Indeed, everything that is in the heavens and the earth, yours is the dominion, O Lord, and you exalt yourself as head over all. Both riches and honor come from you, and you rule over all, and in your hand is power and might, and it lies in your hand to make great and to strengthen everyone. Wow, that's a lot. See, he's saying in one word, God is sovereign over all. He's sovereign. Say sovereign. And because he's sovereign, he can do all things. And that means that whatever you need, he's able to do. And that's why you already praise him. You praise him before that which you've asked for happens because you already know that he's sovereign enough, because he rules over all things, he's able to bring it to you. Can you imagine where David is right now? He didn't just say that. He said that indeed everything that is in the heavens and the earth, amen, he is sovereign over everything that is in the heavens and the earth. He didn't say, you're sovereign over everything in my life, everything in my family, everything in our local church, everything in Deerfield and Boca, over America. You're sovereign over everything in the earth and the heavens. So David, as he talked with God, he understood who God was. And he didn't just go to God and not understand God. He lets us know that his thinking was beyond the natural realm in his extolling and praising God. You see, he praised God for all creation because all of creation is good for us, amen, in the natural, because God made everything, amen, and then he made man. And he made everything first because he made everything for man. So everything that God made, you thank God for the trees. You thank God for the atmosphere. You thank God for the stars. You thank him for the sun. You praise him for all of that because he did all of that for you. David had an understanding of the depth of his God, of his father, of Abba, his dad. He knew that he had created things and he made things not just for his own good, but for us, for our well-being. After he made man, he put us in the best place on the planet. He put us in the garden, a well-watered place. See, wherever there's water, there's growth. Well-watered, there's growth. And he put him, the definition of the garden is a well-watered place, the Garden of Eden. Look to your neighbor and say, in Christ, I'm in a well-watered place. See, God placed you back in the garden before the fall. As it was, as Adam was, so are you in Christ. Look to your neighbor and say, I'm just like Adam before the fall. I'm pure because of the blood of Christ. See, you're not a, look to your neighbor and say, don't say you're a sinner saved by grace. Say, I was a sinner saved by grace. Bible says, if you should fall, if you should sin, when we come into Christ, we're born into the perfection of Christ, the holiness of Christ. And we're being made perfect, but we are not sinners. We crossed over from sin. We can cross back over to sin if we choose to. But if I don't choose to, then I remain righteous in Christ. Without sin. Hear what I'm saying? So don't look at yourself. Don't say, I'm a sinner. You're a saint now. You are a saint. Tell everybody Pastor Billy said that I'm a saint. You know why I said it? No, I mean when you leave here, tell everybody. You can tell everybody now. It's not just for the Catholic Church to call people saints. See, they based upon if a person does a miracle, amen, or miracles follow their lives, they canonize them, they authorize them, they ordain them, canonize them as a saint. But that's not scripture. The Bible calls all believers in Christ saints. To the saints, to the church, to the saints at Ephesus, to the church at Ephesus. Come on, it's the saints, to all the saints. Look to your neighbor and say, you are a saint now in Christ. You ain't a ain't. You ain't a ain't. I had to do that. I couldn't hold that. You are not an ain't. You are not a sinner. You're not a sinner. You used to be a sinner that was saved by grace. When Christ showed up through Christ, If he didn't show up, I would still be a sinner. I would still be in my sins. But when Christ came, he delivered me from all of my sins, out of all of my sins. He delivered me out of all of my sins. And now I am brought into his marvelous light, the light of his glory, the light of the glory of Christ, God with us, Emmanuel walking in the flesh. I live and dwell inside of Christ Jesus. And the devil would love for my thinking to believe that I am still a sinner. How? When Christ has set me free from sin. How am I still a sinner if Christ has set me free from sin and death? I am no longer in sin. I am no longer a sinner. And I am no longer on my way to hell. But I am a saint. I am in Christ Jesus. And I am on my way to heaven. Somebody give God praise. That's where you're on your way to, saints. Saints. Hello, saints. Good morning, saints. Yes. Hey. Hallelujah. You are saints of the Most High God. And all the creation, everything in this earth's atmosphere, to the heavens, to the earth, underneath the earth, to the oceans, the ecosystem, all of that was for you. And he gave it all to us. He said, you take dominion over and rule over. David understood that. To you, I praise you. To you is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory. In all things that we see, it's because of you. You deserve this. Indeed, everything that is in the heavens and the earth, yours is dominion. There is nothing that you cannot give God praise for. There is always something that you can give God praise for. When David extends it to the heavens and the earth, there's always something you can find to give God praise for. God had me do this, and I'm going to let you go. God said, son, praise me for you. He said, yes, I praise you, Lord, for my salvation. He said, no, praise me for you. Start with your pinky. So I said, Father, I thank you for my pinky. He said, yeah. He said, okay, keep going. I thank you for my next finger, my index finger. I thank you for my thumb. I thank you for my fingernail. Watch what happens when you begin to do that. There's so much. There's always something. There's never a time when there is nothing that you can thank God for. Walk carefully in the days that we're living. Because of Daniel 12, where he says that knowledge shall increase, as the angel told Daniel, as Gabriel told Daniel. But Daniel said, when are all these things going to happen? Which is the end of the age, or the last days, the Bible calls it. And the angel says, men shall travel to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. So walk carefully, church, as believers, as saints, because we're in the days of information overload. Which means you and I are without excuse concerning the things of God. So walk carefully so that you will remember to always give God the praise for whatever he has done. And he's done things for you because you've prayed and asked him, and he's done things before you prayed, before you came into Christ, because he's already given you a gift of faith. He's given you all spiritual gifts. Amen. He tells us that. But he gives us things we've prayed for. But if he didn't give you anything, there are things that you can praise him for. So be careful. David said, why is my soul so downcast? Something happened. Amen. The Philistines came and they took all of the women and the children, and he had to go and get them back when he wrote this. And all of his men were against him. You let us down. They're all going, what are we going to do? So he went alone by himself, and he's like, why are you so downcast? And he realized that he had a God. He served a God that is able. And because God is able to do great things, he began to just praise God. He began to remember who God was. And as he praised God, amen, as he encouraged himself, he remembered all the things that God did. Come on. And he encouraged himself. And he got himself back up to the place of from discouragement to hope to action. And he got up after he encouraged himself in the Lord. The Bible says he encouraged himself in the Lord. So as he began to praise God and remember what God did and was thankful for it, amen, you know, God began to work his miracle in David. You see, the Bible tells us that God so loves us that he gave us his spirit. Come on. And we don't know how to pray sometimes, but God starts to pray through us. Come on, somebody. Because God loves you so much, he doesn't want you to stay in that place. He wants to raise you back up. Come on, somebody. So when the problem is so big and it's just beat you upside your head and you're so wearied and you don't know which way is up, the Holy Spirit will come in there and start lifting you up. Come on, somebody. He'll just start getting about. You're not going out like this. We're not going out at all. It's not over yet. And he just starts rising up inside of you, and all of a sudden you start to stand up and you start to wake up and you start to come to yourself and you start to say, I can. Come on, somebody. And so David was down, and yet he began to encourage himself in the Lord and what God has done, and started to praise God for what God has done, and he started to change his countenance. He started to have hope again. He started to have faith again, and he got back to his former position, come on, of leader, come on, somebody, of boldness, of a warrior. Look to somebody and say, I'm a warrior like my dad. The Bible says God is a warrior. The Lord is a warrior. Come on, somebody, tell your other neighbor, I'm a warrior like my dad. He don't back down. Come on, he steps up to the fight. He runs to the, come on, somebody, amen. So David encouraged himself, and he began to become back to himself, amen, as he thought and praised God for what God did. Come on, somebody. And not only that, he got up to the point where he was back to his old self, and his boldness was ever greater. And he said, God, those daggone devils and took our kids, them devils and took our wives. God, should I go and pursue? Because, God, you know who I am. You know who I am, God. You know I'll go after them. You know I'll go. God, you can, should we go? God said, yeah, go. Pursue. And you're going to overtake. And you're going to recover all. Look to somebody and say, my God is able. That's why I praise him when I'm down. I praise him when I'm up. Come on, somebody. I praise him in every state that I'm in. I'm going to give God praise. I'm going to focus in these end times. And I'm going to make sure that I give God praise. I'm going to make sure that I know who my Father is. I got to have a relationship with God. Look to somebody and say, keep your relationship. Keep your relationship. Keep your prayer life. Keep your prayer life. Tell them, keep your prayer life. Tell them, stay in the secret place. Talk to God so that you can know God. And the Bible says, they that know their God shall do great exploits. You need to high five your neighbor and say, get ready for some more great exploits. High five somebody. Come on, high five somebody. Tell them, get ready for some more great exploits. Did she high five you? All right, you're good. You give me a check. You got a check plus. Oh, go ahead. Get ready for some more great exploits. See, the devil tries to distract you so that you can get away from God, and you can get so caught up and confused that you forgot what God did. Because if you just praise him for what he did, which David remembered what he did, and he began to encourage himself, well, God did this and God did that. Come on, somebody. He can do this. God delivered me from the lion. He delivered me from the bear. He can definitely do this. Devil, you're coming down. Giant, you're coming down. Devil, you're coming down. Giant, you're coming down. Look to somebody and say, don't give the devil no space. I said, tell your other neighbor, devil, don't give the devil no space.
Don't give him no place. Don't give him no room. Don't give him an inch, because he's going to try and take a mile. Don't give him an inch. Don't give him a centimeter. Don't give him a millimeter. Don't give him a nanometer. Yes, sir, I don't give him nothing. Look at me. Come on, church, stand to your feet. I got to let you go. Stand to your feet. Look at me. Come on. Don't give him no room. Look to your neighbor and say, don't give him nothing. Don't give him nothing. Don't give him anything. Don't give him nothing. Don't give it to him through your son. Don't give it to him through your daughter. Don't give it to him through your husband, through your wife. We all have to come up. Look to your neighbor and say, don't give it. Come on, don't give it. Don't let him have it through your son, through your wife, through your daughter. Come on, come on, come on. Everybody that hung around David, they had to change. Because what was on David was on them. God supernaturally connected them. He binded them together. Brothers, amen. Listen, men in this house, I pray that God begins to show you my heart, that it's a heart for his heart, and that you bond with me so that we can be men of God, not just men, but men of God. You don't have to be the preacher. Let me preach. Come on. You don't have to be the teacher. Let me teach. But when you go outside of this house, let everybody know that you're a man of God. Hey, Sundere Boshanda. Come on, somebody. It's in your walk. It's in your talk. You're smooth. The Holy Ghost got you. There's no worry. Come on, because God's got your back. He's already provided, and you remember what he's done, and you just, all your job is to praise him. Just tell somebody all your job is to just praise him. 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 That's your job. Oh, my God is good. Don't you know my God? Don't you know what he can do? See, the devil wants to take us off of him. He wants to take the conversation away from him. You bring it to him. Keep it to him. And watch what God does. Somebody give God praise. He encouraged himself in the Lord. He began to praise God. When you praise God, God is going to stir up what he placed in you. Watch God do it. Look to your neighbor and say, won't he do it? Tell three people, won't he do it? Tell three people, won't he do it? Tell them, I know he will. Tell them, tell four people, tell five people, I know he will. Tell them, I know he will. He did, and he is again. He's going to do it again. Hallelujah. Somebody give God praise. I got to let y'all go. It's two things I got to do. I got to take the offering. How many ready to give? And then I got to pray for married couples. Come on, somebody. There's three married couples I definitely have to pray for today. By the Spirit, you're dealing with stuff. And guess what? That's what church is for. That's what prayer is for. God told me we're going to pray. Amen. How many want your marriages to be strengthened? I got my hand up. Amen. Amen. So come on, let's give to the Lord. Let's give our offerings. Amen. And then we're going to come up, those that need prayer. Amen. And I would like all of you to come, but really three of you guys need to come. I want to pray for you. Amen. Now listen, please, call the church. I'd love to talk with you. Many of you may have questions about the church. Many of you have been here, and you probably never really sat down with me. Amen. So thank you. So come on and call the church. Let's have a meeting. I just want to meet you. You want to talk to me? If you want to meet me, come on, and we'll do that. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Because I want to know your heart, and if there's anything specific, please, that you want to tell me, you want to have a little time, just call the church and let's do that. Amen. And as we're growing, I have system pastors that meet with people. Amen. Some of our other ministers meet and talk with people. I want to make you guys aware that we do have security based off of the recent shooting and prior to that. We do have security here. We have guys that are carrying weapons. Amen. And women. And so know that we do all we can to make sure that we're protected here. Amen. And so these are people who are licensed to carry concealed weapons. And we do what we need to do. Amen. Our guys are trained. They watch people. Listen, our guys
our faithful guys, our ushers, our hostesses help. We have eyes on people coming in. They can recognize new people. And that's what they do. Amen. So we can worship freely. We can trust God. Amen. How many know we do all we can and we're good? And that's it. And we're gonna praise God, man. I'm coming to church. Amen. Come on. I'm going to the streets. Amen. I'm going to do what God wants. You guys ready to give? Stand to your feet if you're ready to give. Remember, we're giving abundantly. How are we giving? How are we giving? Amen. Now listen to this. Somebody say 100% tithers. Now I want you to hold your hand up, your offering, amen, and I want you to commit with me to make sure that your prayer, you pray that our church becomes 100% tithing church. Go ahead. Say, I commit that this church, my church, becomes 100% tithing and giving church. That means every time we come into the house of God, we bring an offering and we bring our tithe if we've earned a tithe. Amen? And we give what belongs to God. And that settles it. Let's move on to kingdom business. That's business. Let's take care of that. Evangelism is business. Sitting there learning, having guest preachers, it's all kingdom business. Let's do business. Come on, somebody. Look to your neighbor and say, let's keep doing business. His business. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you that we have seed to give. And we offer this back to you with a pure heart in honor as we are praising you in the mega praise time, 40 days of praising. For all that you've done, we worship you, we thank you, we praise you, we thank you, Father, in this mega time of thanksgiving for all that you've given us as we give back to you. We thank you that you're giving back to us, good measure pressed down, shaken together, and running over, that you're using men to give unto our bosom. We expect harvest. We expect mega. We expect the supernatural increase in Jesus Christ's name. Amen and amen. Come on, somebody shout supernatural increase.
Great and mighty is he.
Hallelujah. When you put it in, say, I expect a harvest. Amen. Come on, shout it out. I expect a harvest.
Great and mighty is he.
I expect a harvest. Hallelujah. Come on and stand to your feet.
Throne in glory. Great and splendor.
I want the married couples to just start heading up here. I want to pray for you before you leave. Hallelujah. And if your spouse is not here, come on, I'm going to pray. Amen. As you stand in proxy. Glory to God. All of you that are remaining, please stand. I'm going to dismiss you. But before I dismiss you, I have to do this. If you're here and you need to give your life to the Lord, just wave your hand. If you want to give your life to the Lord or if you need to rededicate your life, just wave your hand to me. If you've been away from God, you need to recommit, reconnect. Raise your hand. Amen. Everybody's saved. Amen. Glory to God. That's a good thing. Amen. Look to your neighbor and say, I'm so happy for you because if the Lord comes today, you're going to heaven. That's what this is all about at the end that we make it in. Amen. Praise God. Well, I'm going to pray for these married couples and praise God. Just, you can leave, but you can also stay and just stretch your hands as I pray and pray with me. I want you guys to hold hands with your spouse. And if your spouse is not here, just put both hands up, representative of you and him or her. Amen. Amen. Come on up here, honey. Is there anybody already committed to getting married? You're engaged? Raise your hand. No? Okay. All right. Glory to God. Make room, guys. Move over a little, guy, to the left. Yeah, let everyone in. Great, great. So, married couples, hold hands and hold those. The hands that you're holding, if you're both here, hold those up. the middle one. Your right and left hand. Married couples, hold that middle one up like this. Yeah. And single, well, you're by yourself, but you're married. Hold both of them up unto the Lord. Amen. Father, we just thank you for your institution of marriage. Father, we thank you for love that started these marriages. And we pray, Father, that love comes alive again. The fire of love, the flame of love burns brighter and brighter than it ever has in the name of Jesus Christ. God, love for one another, submission to one another, respect and honor for one another. God, giving and sharing to one another. God, planning and preparing for one another, from one another in Jesus Christ's name. Father, we thank you for quiet, calm discussions. We thank you, Father, that there is no animosity, no anger towards one another. We pray that the conversations are spiritual, according to your word, Father, and not to hurt, but to help, to build up, Father, in Jesus Christ's name, to build up. Father, I pray that we build each other up in our marriages, that we, the goal in this mega Thanksgiving season is that we give thanks and show our thanks by giving and hugging and gift giving and listening and extending a hand, Father, and a hug and a kiss. Rekindle the fire of love. God, rekindle it and let us be concerned with our spouses first, then our children, then our friends and co-workers. Family first, husband and wife first. Let it grow, let it flourish like never before. And everything that you meant for evil, devil, our God is going to turn it around for our good. Amen. Father, thank you for turning everything around for our good in our marriages. In Jesus Christ's name, we thank you. We thank you for your peace and understanding. In Jesus Christ's name, hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. Communication is the biggest threat to our marriages, amen. Sex, communication, and money. So I want you to really focus in on being in agreement by the word of God in the spirit in these areas of sex, communication, and money. That in this hour, as you move to God, God is going to move to you. That's what we learned in prayer. Draw nigh to him, he'll draw nigh to you. Go to him in prayer, he'll reward you openly. So both of you agree. Go into prayer to God, asking in agreement, not asking separately, so that when you come out, you will receive from heaven, both of you, everything you touch. It will prosper. It will grow. I speak it over your lives this morning. Everything is growing as you continue to stay connected to God in your marriages and submit it unto the Lord. Amen. God bless you. I love you. And the best is yet to come. I'm excited for all of your marriages here. Amen. You are fine couples. Look at you guys. I'm glad you're proclaimers. Amen. You're part of Proclaim, baby. I love you guys. Amen. Now, why don't you married folk just greet each other and hug each other? That's the married folk hug. And no, Aaron, get back. Y'all hug each other up front, all the married couples, not just you two spouses, but each other. Get the hug, go hug the married couples right here. Yeah, right here. Nothing against the single folk. It's a married thing right here. That's why I want you guys to get married. Who's you guys looking to get married? Let me see that head. Go ahead. You can do it. Do it, baby. I can't wait. It's going to be good. Amen. Let me get some hugs in, too. Bless you in your marriage. Bless you in your marriage.
Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2.
Thank you, Jesus.
The body in the mega. Rivers are flowing in the mega. Rivers are flowing in the mega.
Things are flowing in the mega.
Step on into the mega. Rivers are flowing in the mega. Rivers are flowing in the mega.
Things are
flowing in the mega. Step on into the mega. Rivers are flowing in the mega.
The rivers are flowing in the mega.
In the mega.